Introduction to the Delta-wye transformer connection, part 6b. In this part, we're going to continue our discussion on the voltage phasor diagram for delta transformer connection. And by the end of this part 6 tutorial, not this one, but the part 6 section, we'll have a greater understanding what this illustration means, how it's drawn, and what it represents. We often find this illustration in transformer nameplates as well as engineering drawings. So we want to have a very strong understanding of this connection. So in part 6a, we set up our voltage phasors and we defined VAG, VBG, and VCG. We also said that there is a difference between VAG versus VAB or V-phase A, and that is the key to understanding voltage phasors for the delta connection. Let's just jump right into it, right? So VAB, which is the voltage across line A and line B on the delta side, is equal to the phase A voltage, which is a voltage across winding A. That is also equal to VAG minus VBG, which makes sense, right? VAG is here, which is a voltage across line A and ground, and then VBG is here, which is a voltage across line B and ground. So the voltage across line A and line B is essentially equal to the voltage across line A to ground minus the voltage across line B to ground. Makes sense, right? Okay, so let's evaluate this equation. So I've set something up already. This should look very similar to the examples that we've been doing in our previous tutorials. The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to define our phasor values, right? So I'm going to choose a value for VAG of 2400 volts at 0 degrees. And VBG is again 2400 volts at 240 degrees. And VCG is equal to 2400 volts, 120 degrees. Now, if you haven't caught on already, this is the balanced set of three-phase voltages. And if you're still confused, just click on this link here where you can find a video on balanced power system. Okay. So I'm going to call this phasor VAG because that's how I defined it, right? So VAG is at 0 degrees, and that's the 0 degrees is my reference line, okay? VBG is this phasor here, and VCG is this phasor here. Again, if you're having a hard time understanding this setup, just click on this link and go to that balanced power system video tutorial. Okay, so this right here is an ABC phase rotation. Okay, now we said in our equation that the line-to-line voltage across line A and line B, which essentially equals voltage across our phase A winding for our delta connection, is equal to VAG minus VBG. So here is VAG right here. We're going to perform the head-to-tail method and subtract VAG minus VBG. Okay, so now that we have this visual representation, if we were to relate VAG to VAB, what would we have to do? Well, we would have to shift VAG by 30 degrees. We'd have to shift it by 30 degrees in the counterclockwise direction, okay? And then we would have to multiply it or stretch it, right, by 1.73 or the square root of 3, so it lines up with VAB, okay? So we take VAG, now we have to shift VAG by 30 degrees in the counterclockwise direction, and then we have to multiply it or stretch it by 1.73 so that it overlaps VAB, which means that VAB is equal to the square root of 3 times VAG rotated by 30 degrees. Okay, so this equation here, you see that? So why are we doing this? All right, so let's step back and understand exactly what's going on here and why we're doing this. We want to understand the relationship between VAG and VAB, okay? Because that's what's going to help us understand the voltage phasor diagrams for the delta connection. Is that making sense? If it is, comment on below. And if it's not, then tell me how I can improve these videos. Now, if you haven't already, please do go ahead and subscribe by clicking on the link on the bottom right-hand corner of the screen. The next part, part 6c, we'll go ahead and complete our phasor diagram and show the relationship between these voltages here versus these voltages there. This video was brought to you by GeneralPAC.com, making power system protection, automation, and controls intuitive.